Hello and welcome to part 2 of the table building sessions. Last time ended quite abruptly because I was called away. So we stopped at building this metal rail here, and I was looking for the next part that we could add to the table. And how about this metal packs? We can find them again on the default table, and they are in the upper right corner here. And to select one, I like to move them down here, rotate them, and have a look at them. It's either one of those two, I think. Let's see them in detail down here. Okay, or not. Down here. And I think this one is the one similar to the picture, again with the rubber around it. So we copy this one from the default table to our gold ball. Let's put one here. And the first two have been in this places here. So it's one post and one post. Delete the old ones and put a rubber around them. Of course, not such a huge one. We make it smaller. Oops. Maybe like this. And did we check the rubber color before? In this one they used a white one. And the flyer. The flyer says also white ones. Okay. So this will become two white rubbers. Rubber white. Okay, let's have a look. Two posts with quite large rubbers. Let's make them a bit smaller. Okay, fits around. Nearly. Okay. Same here. Now let's take the other one. Okay, much better. Maybe wrong height. I think for the posts the rubbers are a little bit higher, maybe like 35. Yep, looks better now, maybe like 32 or something. Picture says around here and a little bit thicker maybe. Yeah, it's a little bit thicker. Let's take a 10. Yep, looks more like it. Maybe even 12. Okay. For comparison, seems fine. Next up, let's see what we have. We have here on the left this stuff, two, I don't know, packs and rubbers, and on the real table. And for the left side, I didn't find a good picture, just seems to be two packs and a slingshot. Okay, so we check out this. Is actually not a slingshot, but on the table it looks like it, and even has the hole for the slinger or whatever it's called in English. This one here, Interesting. So first two plastic packs. Remove this stuff and this stuff. Take one of our plastic packs and put them here. One and two. This thing becomes our slingshot. It's already a switch, so it's probably somewhere in the table script with a pretty high elasticity. Not at all, 0.5. Okay, reset that. 0.3. Okay. We have our two packs, then we put a rubber around it. And we'll see. Or maybe this should even get a real slingshot like the other slingshots. Okay, we will add that later, I think. So this will just become a detection if the ball has been hit, and then we will see after that. Okay, I unsmooth this and remove this one, so we have a flat surface for our wall, even though it's maybe not so realistic with a rubber band, but it makes it easier to have the wall be hit-able from top to bottom. Okay, later there will be a slingshot here. Next one. I thought we added some metal packs here, but there are still the old ones, so I will remove this stuff. Okay, cleaned up a little. Now we have two walls, 12A and 12. This one is drop-able, so this seem to be drop targets. Let's see what the picture says. Nope, normal targets. Yellow, normal targets. To have targets that can move a little bit when they are hit, we steal them again from the default table. They are here on the side. At the moment it's a red one, but we can fix that in Photoshop. So we take this one. Wait a second. We take this one. Copy. And put it on our table. Unlock. And see what we have. We have a wall that can be hit by the ball. And we have the primitive that moves from front to back when the wall has been hit. Actually, the wall will not be visible. And this is the old one, number 12 and 12A. So let's remove that one and call this one 12. And this is our 12 primitive. The rotation isn't quite right, so let's see. This looks better, and put it somewhere here. Okay, and put the wall in front of it, so the primitive can be hit. And this is just a toy to move around. Okay, at the moment the target has no image yet. There's an image for the red one in the default table, but we want a yellow one. And I already have created the target in different colors for other tables. It's easy to replace the color in Photoshop. If you have questions there, we can do that in Photoshop later again. And let's take the yellow one. Okay. And add it to the toy. Okay, we have a yellow target. Same with this one and the others. Targets. Let's see what the table script says to the switch 13. There's even a timer. For dropping it and moving it back up. 13, 12, and 14. And we had 12, 13, 14. Okay. So this stuff we don't need anymore. We make it into remarks by pressing Ctrl W. And the same for the three timers. Make it W and actually remove the timers from the table because we don't need them. Or I think we reuse them for the movement of our primitives. The original table has also some programming for them by making them. Oh, this is just a light. By moving it minus 10. So it's like a pushback effect. Make the timer, enable the timer, and the timer pushes it back to original position after some seconds. So we don't need the original timers anymore. 13, 12. Okay, this will be gone. We take one of these for example. 13 has, let's say 12 has been hit. We need the pulse switch. Okay, we copy this one. We don't need the lights. But we need the 12p to go backwards. And after that, we need the 12 go forward again. So we copy it from the default table. 12p will go backwards where it belongs. So 12 is it. That's the wall in front of the primitive. The switch is called. The primitive will move backwards and timer is enabled. The timer is moving back the primitive and the timer disables. And the timer is set in the wall and it's a 50 millisecond timer. So it's very fast movement. That's maybe one reason you don't need more than one animation step there, because it's a very fast movement. These are the old ones we can remove. Remove the old ones and replace the numbers. Numbers have been replaced. And when a ball hits these targets, there should be a nice animation. And this is how they look like. Hard metal packs with this one. Let's compare it to the picture for that. Here the targets are in front of the metal packs, so I think we have to move them forward a little bit. Better. Next up, there's another target here. A square one in the original. Let's see. It's a round one here. It's a round one here. Another yellow one. That's easy. Make another one. I just copied one of the old ones and replaced the numbers and also remarked the two lines. So, another round target. Let's do more metal rails. We have one here. Normally there are two here. They are totally missing at the moment. And these are the final metal rails. Let's see. And I also see we have the metal packs with the rubber here. And they look a bit different from the ones that we used. These are not round on the bottom, but the originals were, so maybe we will take these ones. I think they even look nicer than mine. Mine. Yeah, well, you know what I mean. Unlock. Copy one. Let's see. Remove one. Default table one. Okay, bad comparison. There's something in the way. There's actually a lot in the way. Let's put it back where it belongs. Play. Yeah, similar, but not the same. I'll take the left one. And paste. Okay, another one. Metal rail. We take the metal rails from another table. For example, I think the rock table uses them. Yes, these ones are very easy to use. It's just two walls with a metal texture that are very round, and one ramp that you can move around easily and put them both together. And I think they look quite nice. Make a copy of them. Put one here, and one here. And put them on the right position. Three metal rails added. Let's see what else we have. The pack at the end of the metal rail. Let's see, and there's a gate here. The picture says that it's maybe probably the same as these ones, but maybe not. This picture, even harder to see. Let's browse the pictures a bit. Okay, this seems to be a decent picture of it. Really looks like the same from up here. So we just copy one of them and paste here. Put it on the correct place. Okay, next up we have this metal wall here. Next up, we have this metal wall here that we can put in. Actually, it's already put in, it just needs a better texture. So let's see which parameters we have for this one. Aluminium, metal weight, 0.3, 0.15, 0.3, 3.15. And aluminium and metal 8. The old one is height of 42 only to let some light through. So we do the same here. Collidable. Alright, and for later putting it in a connection, it's a metal wall, some number. And put it on the right place. These two will be replaced later. According to the picture, it goes a little bit over the pack. Actually, we can put the packs in. That would be... packs would look nicer there. So, let's add two more packs. Copy, paste, paste. And put the metal wall in front of the pack a little bit. Then, around the border, and just stopping here. There's another metal rail here. We can add this one. Just copy. Oh, wait a second, we use this one. That's a spare. I don't think we need again. Just replace it with this one. Next one is another gate and two, I don't know, metal packs? packs. Let's see. It's a gate, alright, but the packs are hard to see. Even from this position. So just start with the gate. It's a two-way gate in this one, that's an import error. And remove all the old stuff. Just make it bigger and a little bit higher. The gate just gets some metal material and make it longer so it fits on the pegs. On this one, and this one needs a little bit more and a little bit higher. Okay. 160. The height we will check later when we move the pegs a little bit, because the pegs also seem to be too high because they stick through the plastics. So we'll probably move them down a little bit later. These pegs. Here's a very nice picture of the two pegs we have here, short metal pegs with the gate sitting on top. And the plastic is also very low here, as if the ball will always scratch along the plastic. I wonder if they can withstand the power of the ball a long time. But it seems to be the case on several locations. So these two will be half metal packs, which is interesting, because I haven't seen those before. But doesn't matter, we just fake it and use half of this one probably. Or this one. Okay, that is interesting. I dismantled one of these pieces. It's actually consisting of three pieces. This is just a round cylinder that would be perfect for us. And a screw inside. A real complete screw. Okay, why not? Let's put this together. Back together and use it. They are just lower than normal. Let's remove 25. And have a look. Okay, we can take this. Put the plastic back on, which is very low at 30. Maybe that's even too high. Let's see. No, this seems fine. The screw looks through the plastic. And it's fine. This one is too big for it. Well, that's because we can't have... we don't have gates that are high on one side and low on the other. Which is a pity, but this is like it is. Let's put it over one pack. And the other... it just looks like this. Okay. Next up. What is on here? And another pack. Okay, on this side we have another one of the metal packs, two normals and a rubber on them. So let's put them in. Okay, let's check if this wall is a switch. Wall 178. Nope, not in the script. So, remove it. Then here's another metal wall. See how it looks like? Goes from here to up here. It's another aluminium. Metal 08, aluminium. Metal 08. Yes. And height 42 to let some light through. Elasticity like the others. And put it on the correct position. So that's another metal one. The pegs we can't see from here. Let's see if I find another picture. Didn't find another picture, but I see here that there's another metal rail. So on here there is another metal rail, but a lower one. Is it supposed to be okay? Let's take one from down here and put it in the right position. On this picture it seems to be a normal pack with a rubber around it, so it's probably the same up here. This wall, it's another slingshot, like on this side, SW27C. So let's keep this as a slingshot for later. And place it with our plastic packs. Which one is next? We have something in here. Let's see what that is. The table says it's another screenshot. It back together, and we have this one over here. Looks like another slingshot. Now for the big one on top. Big metal rail, two gates. Let's just use them. Makes them a bit higher, maybe. I like the 60s. Give them a metal one. Metal material. The big metal rail on top is just a single rail going from A to B. So this is just one little metal thing. I think I will replace it with our ramp that we normally use. I think this will look quite nice. So I take one of the metal ramps and put it here. We have our very long metal rail. That is actually very low. It's a ramp type 1 wire lock. Two plastic packs. Let's see where we find two plastic packs in white that look a little bit like these ones. It's half size only. White with a little bit on top. Interesting form. I don't think we have something like this, and I'm not a 3D master, so what's similar? Little on top is here, but this is ripped. There's a little on top only. This looks very nice. So let's take this one. Number 3 has a plastic white material. So it's one here. And one here. Okay, with the correct material, maybe. Okay, I don't have the material, so I export it. And now I have a white plastic material. Let's move the table down a bit to have a better look. And the height seems okay, but move a little bit to the back. Move the metal a little bit. This looks much better. All right. We have an empty pack here, which should be, and this should be one of these, and this should go over there. All right. The packs look through the plastic, so we should move them down a little bit. So let's make a collection of all the pack plastic. New collection. Packs. And so we can move them down all at once. A little bit like minus 5. They still look through. So let's try, I think minus 8 was a value. Yes, now with minus 8 they don't look through the plastics anymore. It looks like the sling gates are flying on top of the plastics. So they're even higher than the normal plastics. On top of the packs, I mean. So let's move them down a little bit. Let's see how much we have to move them down. Okay. For convenience, make a group. Guards. I don't know if I need it again, but height is 40. Let's do it 25. This looks much better, actually. The plastics, the packs now look through the lane gate, so maybe it's too low. Let's see, 30.